The evening of Friday 30th, July 2021 was impactful to Okwaibomites who witnessed the life-touching presentation of Heartland Alliance Limited by Guarantee Achievement in Okwaibom State and beyond. As the non-governmental organization hosts the Honorable Commissioner for Health, Dr. Augustine Omo, and his counterpart in the Women Affairs and Social Welfare Ministry, Dr. Inie Diakpan, and other stakeholders at the ultra-modern one-stop shop in Uyo, which have just been registered to function as a full-fledged clinic. Declaring the event, which had the presence of stakeholders, dignitaries and participants across the country open, the Heartland Alliance Limited by Guarantee Chief Executive Officer Mr. Bartholomew Ochenne introduced the organization board members, which was led by the board vice chair Mrs. Olayine Akani, to the commissioners and others present.
So, Dr. Olayine is here representing her. And, we also have Dr. Obembe, AIG retired. We have Navy Captain Akuburo.
Responding to the beautiful stories of hope and impact of Heartland Alliance to Okwaibomites, the Commissioner for Health, Dr. Augustine, expressed gratitude for what Heartland Alliance is doing in Okwaibom State. He applauded them for what they have on ground and the impact their intervention is having on epidemic control in the state among KPS. He specifically commended them for seeing that the OSS is registered in the state, which made him present.
I'm impressed with that, and I thank God and I am for doing that. We could only have been able to do this with all the passion that you've shown. You were really committed to it, because it's not, it's a difficult area of insight. When you step in there, you see the challenges of humanity, really, let me put it that way. But you see what we can solve it and bring it up. That's good. And it's also good to see that the persons from which we work with are out there to show support. I mean, to appreciate what you are doing. And I agree that you put their stories forward. Now, that's usually quite some degree of confidence that people repose in what they think that Kadla Alliance.
He called on the organization to keep up good works, as His Excellency, the Executive Governor of Okwaibom State, Mr. Dom Emmanuel, is passionate about ensuring that every Okwaibomite and visitors working here are comfortable.
His Excellency, Governor Dom Emmanuel, is passionate ensuring that every Okwaibomite and everyone working in Okwaibom attains the base level of health. Okay. For reasons for which you can see has made significant investment into health. So HIV and all that we're working, we seem to have addressed. But the one that it seems to has gotten angry or seems to have gotten angry that we are not addressing it very well is challenging us now, and you can be rest assured that with the support of His Excellency will address it too. And that's the challenge of COVID-19.
The commissioner decried the ravaging effects of COVID-19 third wave in Okwaibom State and called on Heartland Alliance to join hands in the campaign against the spread.
We had about one case at the beginning of this month. At the end of that first week, we had about five. As of today, as we speak, we have 448 positive cases. So I just wanted to imagine the plateau. We said this. research is not exactly what we are talking about.
On his part, the Commissioner for Women Affairs and Social Welfare, Dr. Ini Adiakpan, said she doves her cap for the giant strides of Heartland Alliance in Akwa Ibom State and promised to schedule an appointment for the organization to meet with the wife of the governor of Akwa Ibom State for continuous partnership.
I do that acknowledging that this is one programming area that a lot of people do not go into. And when people go into this programming area, I drop my heart for them. Because it has their own challenges. And it's only the adults that go in there. But sincerely, I want to say, you've done a very great work. And we had talked, and I had also mentioned to Her Excellency, that she has a very tight schedule. And I know whenever she's free, I had mentioned you to her. And I know whenever she comes in and we're free, and I can let this be, I would want to, she would also want to meet with you. Thank you.
Earlier in her presentation, Dr. Ngozi Noel Ogamba, while recounting her organization giant strike, said Heartland Alliance works in 3 states, 8 zones, 60 LGAs, and 14 one-stop shops. She stated they are working in the 31 local government area of Akwa Ibom State, 18 local government areas in Cross River State, 17 USID delineated LGA in Lagos, Nigeria.
This is where we work. KPK1 project actually is being implemented in 3 states in Nigeria, Lagos, Akwa Ibom, and Cross River States. We're working in the 31 LGAs of Akwa Ibom, and Cross River States, we are working in the 18 LGAs of Cross River States.
The indefatigable state team lead gave a rundown of our organization's collaboration and partnership with stakeholders in different sectors in the state. She shared a life-changing opportunities according to a 30-year-old female brothel-bear sex worker who tested positive to HIV when she was 27. Also, a 29-year-old non-brothel female sex worker, mother of two, who got help from the gender bias violence intervention and mental health physical supports of the organization, trafficked female sex workers who were referred to the one-stop shop. A stranded MSM provided with transit home.
Under government, we are partnering with the Office of the Senior Special Assistant to the Governor of Multinational and General Agencies, Office of the Executive Governor through the Office of Chief of Staff, National Agency for the Control of AIDS NACA, Local Agency for Control of AIDS LACA, State Ministry of Health, that's why our prof is seated here with us, Akwa Ibom State Agency for the Control of AIDS, that's AK SACA, International Federation of Female Lawyers. Yes, because we, in recent time, we found out that we had a lot of rape cases to deal with, and we actually have one that we're going to be talking about in the course of the presentation. We also are partnering and collaborating with the Primary Healthcare Development Agency, State Ministry of Women Affairs and Social Development. And then under law enforcement agencies, we have National Drug Law Enforcement Agency. We are partnering with them. We also are partnering with the Nigerian Police Force, because we understand who our target audience are, and sometimes they could run into problems. Police also go to raid our brothels and bombs, so it's also good that we partner with the police and the NDLA. Then Police Action Committee on AIDS, Nigeria Correctional Center. We work so well in the prisons because they are also part of our key, part of our target audience, so we also do a lot of intervention there. So this is how our LGAs are distributed in Akwa Ibom State alone. Like I said, we are working in the 31 LGAs of Akwa Ibom, and we have 4 one-stop shops. We have one at Ikote Bene, and under that one at Ikote Bene, we have those 10 LGAs feeding into the one-stop shop at Ikote Bene. And for this Uyo OSS where we are seated, we have 8 LGAs feeding into this OSS. And then for Oron OSS, we have 5 LGAs feeding into the Oron one-stop shop. And then for Eke OSS, we have 8 LGAs feeding into that one-stop shops.
The commissioners finally endorsed their presence at the one-stop shop by appending their signatures. The commissioners, Heartland Alliance board members, and other visitors were conducted around the different units of the one-stop shop. The event also featured the presentation of furniture to the network of people living with HIV and AIDS in Nigeria, Akwa Ibom State Chapter, NIFAM, ably represented by the state coordinator, Mrs. Elizabeth Samson Udoo. Others who spoke at the event were the Chief Operation Officer Heartland Alliance, Mrs. Mary Adebowale, Mrs. Olayine Akani, Dr. Fumilayo Ogembe, Assistant Inspector General retired, Mr. Charles Donglong, Navy Captain Emmanuel Akumbori retired, Dr. Agro Geoffrey, Director of Public Health, State Ministry of Health, Dr. Mrs. Enoata, Executive Secretary, Primary Health K Board, Dr. Celeste Akpan, Deputy Director of Medical Services, Dara Udoma for Credo TV Show.